Welcome. In this video, we're going to create this illustration from that very basic drawing. We will only be using Photoshop, so let's get to work. To start, I imported my drawing to Photoshop. You can open the project at any size. I use 16:9 ratio since it will be real. One trick is here, creating different layers for some part of the drawing, if you place people, plant, or something behind them. You will understand more later. Then what I'm gonna do is creating a background layer or paint the existing layer. I paint it white for now and change name of it. Now we will add texture. First, I import the texture I want to use to Photoshop on a different window. Then go to edit and define pattern and give name. It is added to your library, I will show you in a minute. Coming back to main window. Take the magic wand tool to select the part that you apply texture. Create new layer and paint this new layer. I generally paint it white because it's easier to control in my opinion. But you can paint it any color of course, depending on your work. Double click the layer and on the window click pattern overlay. Come to the pattern, click the little arrow and at the end or first, if it's your first pattern, you will see the texture you created. Click it and it's placed your drawing. I will make the opacity 100 and arrange its scale. You can edit according to your project. You can also play with the blending mode. In my project, they didn't make such difference, but in yours, it may will. Also play with the angle if necessary. I also add inner shadow to make it more realistic. To see clearly, I make the opacity 100, but later I will decrease it. Actually, there is no certain values or distance, size, etc. You will play with them and choose the values that felt more realistic. Here I decide it's too sharp, so I add a little more. Texture part is done. For other part, I select the parts again with magic wand tool. Also, to select all of them at once, be sure to add to selection is on from the toolbar. Again, creating a new layer and this time I paint some bluish gray. Doing same things to window frames, I choose lighter gray for this. Also, for the windows, I painted them to light blue color. Take the drawing layer to top if you want to see the lines. If you don't, then you can leave it to bottom. I'm applying inner shadow to gray parts and the windows with the little arrangements of size. Then for the bricks, I add cover overlay. It's very useful tool if you are not happy with the color of your texture. With blending mode, especially multiple one, you can achieve very realistic results. I also find inner glow very useful to achieve more realism. Again, there is so many options to try, even the shape of the glow. You can only find the proper one by trying them all. For the sky, create new layer and choose a blue or any color that is proper to your illustration. Here I am trying a couple of blue. Now I will add some cloudish moves. For that, take the eraser tool. Be sure the one with soft edge is selected. Make its size bigger by pressing Alt. Decrease opacity and click it randomly, maybe twice on some parts. They will look very natural. Now, to give our drawing more life, I add birds. To make it blend with the rest of the illustration, I decrease this opacity. I also add a tree look like it's growing in some part of the camera. Go to Image, Hue and Saturation to match the color of tree with other. Play with the values till the color satisfies you. Also, again you can add color overlay. I ran some plants in balconies. I found this on the website Creepy, by the way. There are tons of creepy engines. You should check definitely. Taking the railing layer upside of the plants since they are behind of the railings. Adding other plants. If your plant space doesn't match your building space, to delete the part, right-click plant layer and click Rasterize layer. Select the part with one of the selection tools and press delete on your keyboard. After placing all of them, to edit them all at once, select all plant layers, right-click and merge layers. But don't do that if they are not in same color or contrast. Now with the layer selected, go to Image, Adjustments, and Edit Colors and Lights. Also place some people, realistic or silhouette, whatever you like more. I wanted to add a people inside the building. To reflect it, right-click and click Flip Horizontal. Arrange its position and take the layer under the glass layer. Since glass layer is opaque, we cannot see a human now. To fix it, decrease the opacity of glass. Yes, now it looks more alive, definitely. Delete the parts that behind the window frames. Also here placing a cute cat inside. Merging all human layers and editing them. And some final touches. I am gonna add some filters to whole image, so I will create a copy of all layer but in one layer. To do that, press Alt plus Ctrl plus Shift and plus E. Here you can see the copy layer of the whole image. Go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. Edit its light, colors, and effects. I like to add grain effects to illustrations, so increasing the grain value. Here, decreasing the saturation value of the color that I want to neutralize. So here is the final look, guys. I hope you like it. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and drop your thoughts in comments. See you!